the lesson, okay? So I'd like you, I'd like everybody to put their pencils down. We're just waiting for one person to put her pencil down. So, we've been studying this continent. Does anyone remember what this continent is called?
Yes. North America.
North America, okay. And Nasir, I'd like you to come sit up here. Okay, thank you. So this is North America. We've studied North America, and we know that there are many countries in North America. Who could point to the United States on this puzzle map? Nasir. Okay. Zoe, will you make sure you get everybody's faces too? Okay, Nasir, could you do that again? Could you? Okay, so that's the United States. The United States is a huge country, but it is part of North America. And the United States, as we know, is the country in which we live. So here is the United States, okay? And what we're going to be talking about right now is our state and the states around it, okay? So this is our state, and we know what it's called. What is it called?
Minnesota.
Minnesota. We live in Minnesota like some people live in Florida. And some people live in Texas, and some people live in California. Some people live there, and their whole lives are lived there, just like our whole lives are in Minnesota. Okay, so within our country, there are 50 states. Our country is divided up into 50 states. Other countries don't have states. That's just how our country is. Some might, but some countries just have regions, some countries just have cities, but the way the United States is organized is where there are 50 states. The land is divided into 50 states.
One country from a different continent just like it's been around there. My big brother said it's small.
So thank you for sharing that, Nasir. So our land of North America is huge, and it's really has totally different landscapes. If you lived here in California, you would be very familiar with the ocean, the Pacific Ocean. Okay, like Lucy's aunt. If you lived along this coastline here, in one of these many states, you would really be familiar with the Atlantic Ocean. If you lived in Colorado, you would be familiar with mountains. Does anyone know what we are especially known for?
Our snow?
Lakes. And our snow. But we know lakes here, don't we?
Yeah.
We're familiar with lakes. And That is what our country,
not
I mean not our country, our state, our state is known for. Okay, so here we are. Okay. Now, boys and girls, is there a big line somewhere, a big crack in the earth that separates Minnesota from everything else? No. People have agreed that Minnesota stops at a certain point and that other states start at that point. And sometimes it makes a really funny edge. Sometimes it's a super straight edge. Do you see how
it just looks like a square?
Right. And they're all different. Now this is where I am from. This is Michigan. And look at the shape of this. What does this shape look like?
It does look like a penguin. Person.
Yeah, it does. It looks like a bear standing up with a small hand.
So what we call it in Michigan is we call it the mitten.
A mitten.
So do you see this? It's like the shape of a mitten. Okay. And then that's this is the lower peninsula. And then we have the strip of land up here. We call that the rabbit.
It's supposed to be a rabbit.
Okay, so here and here.
Oh, I see the rabbit now, but I don't see the glove in that.
Okay. So this is the big mitten.
Uh-huh.
And this is the running rabbit on top.
What? How is it?
It doesn't look exactly like one.
No.
It looks like his legs are stretched out.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or like a squirrel with a bushy tail.
So not only are states in a square or a rectangle or a jagged shape. Yeah, look at this. That would be a really great thing to research. So this is how Minnesota is shaped. And Minnesota has states all around it. Except to the north. Because this line is where Canada begins. So I would like you to take that. I'd like you to take that. I'd like you to take that.
Me?
And I would like you to take that.
How about me?
Okay. So I'd like everyone to hold their questions for a little while. Everybody. Not everybody gets one each time we listen. Okay? But I know you get them sometimes, right? Okay. All right. So here's Minnesota. Here she is. Okay. Who has Wisconsin?
Okay. I'm going to drive to Wisconsin.
I have Wisconsin.
Okay, that's Wisconsin, our neighbor to the east. And we live so close to Wisconsin. Probably a lot of us have been to Wisconsin.
I have. Right? My aunt lives in Wisconsin. Okay. I have probably like 3 times.
Great. Now, our neighbor to the south is Iowa.
Yay, not Iowa.
Does anyone here know anybody from Iowa, or have you been to Iowa?
Nope.
Okay.
I have no idea.
Okay, so that's to the south of us. To the east of us, there are two countries. Two states. Yes, thank you, Nasir. First, North Dakota. Okay. And South Dakota. Okay. So this is the United States. We've looked at just our region around Minnesota. And we're part of a big country called
United States.
And then we're part of a bigger continent called
North America.
Okay, great. So your follow-up works. Is to trace Minnesota in its neighboring countries. In neighboring states.
Wait, that's it?
I am going to explain. I hear a lot of people blurting right now. And I need all hands down so I can fully explain it, because your questions might be answered if I just explain it. This is the one assignment you need to do. It is to trace these using the puzzle shapes, finding out the names of all the states in an atlas, writing in the states, going over it with Sharpie, spelling it.
Right.
And why do we need to spell it right?
So people know what it says.
Right, and so it's our most beautiful work.
And if you don't know how to spell it, you can just go over there.
Right. So is there any reason not to spell it correctly?
No.
Okay. So this is what I would like you to trace. And then use these colors very beautifully to fill in the states using these exact colors. Now, there's also a challenge work, but I want you to start with this. The challenge work is going to take a long time. It's not going to be finished today or this week. That would be to do the whole country. But what did I say we need to do first?
This.
This is the work I'm expecting for you to have done.
So if you're going to do the whole country,
that's going to be after. You could, or it's going to be separate. This is the priority. Can you stop, please, Josiah? Okay. So what does it mean when I say beautiful work? Yes.
Writing it good and coloring it with nice colors.
Okay, is it just coloring it with nice colors, or is it coloring it with a certain kind of attitude? Nasir. And so what do you mean? So
color the states the same color.
As this.
Yellow, so
yes. Right, exactly. And what else?
Also, it means not sloppy spelling.
Right. Not sloppy spelling, yes.
Do Montessori coloring.
Yes, so Montessori coloring is, so like, let's say this is the state of Minnesota. Okay.
Okay.
It's not great.
No.
But
looks like a seahorse head.
When we color, one way we could color, and I will just, is I could go like this. Okay.
No.
And then there's another way I can color. Could you please stop drumming? It's just like this. So I'm going carefully around the edges, so I don't even have to go over the edges. I'm sort of coloring the edges in first,
and then
the inside. And I also, I don't have to color like this. I can press really lightly and just make my movements really controlled and exact and fill it in as beautifully as I can.